Peter had walked with Jesus. Peter saw the good that my wife was relating to, that Jesus had done, past tense and current event was doing. Peter saw that. But this, it takes the anointing of the Spirit of God to reveal who Jesus is.
Yes.
Many men walked with Jesus, but knew him not.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely.
They knew him not.
Mm-hmm.
Another scripture comes to me, line upon line, precept upon precept.
Mm-hmm.
Here a little, there a little. We perceive who Jesus is through the written word of God, anointed with the Spirit of God. And Jesus told Peter, he said, Simon Bar-Jonas, who's revealed this in you? But it took the anointing of the Spirit of God to allow Peter to perceive who Jesus was. And then another statement we've heard many times over the years. What you do, speak so loud, I can't hear who you say you are. What I do is who I am.
That is true.
What I do is who I am. I must decrease that he may increase. There is an accumulation. You're gathering together. We're a body of Christ. If so be that he's added to the body. Thank you, Lord. There's an accumulation. But then there's a process of assimilation.
Mm-hmm.
The only way I can be a part of you, Brother Zonneville, is to be assimilated with you. Beautiful word you have spoken, because it's true. You were speaking from life's events. You are not a mythologist, but you were speaking from your experience. I can only speak, and each one of us can only speak. Here a little, there a little. Ever day's life events. We have to overcome Satan. And the key, you have to have the keys to the kingdom.
Yes.
In order to become a part in the form of an overcomer. If we don't have the keys of the kingdom, then we won't have the ability to unlock the Word of God and to perceive who Jesus is. Thank you, Lord, for not just the hearing, but the understanding. Peter understood who Jesus was. Thank you, Lord. We're in a precious accumulation of God's children. You say, how do you say that? All men are not, or all mankind are not called to the body of Christ. Jesus said it. He said, there's many among us that's not of us. Do you know what he was really saying? They have not been added. How many times over the years have you attended church? church covers one service after another, and you see new people come in to the church. You see, even, you know what the inheritance of God's people is? Is the wealth of the ungodly. Think of this. That's our inheritance. How many times have you ever seen God place an unsaved, ungodly person into the church with a pocket full of money? Personality is not important in what I'm saying. Small minds deal with personality. Great minds deal with principles. The greatest principle in existence for mankind is the written word of God anointed with the Spirit. Then we've seen people, you have a church, have a need. We're a small group. There's no millionaires among us. But how many times have we seen God send an ungodly person for a season to meet a need? God always cares for them that are His. He said He knows them that are here. It's a wonderful, wonderful, secure, a peaceful and a secure place to be, to know who Jesus is. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. It's a blessing, Brother Joel, to see you and the dear sister. When I walked in, there was an illumination in my spirit when I saw you two. And you're saying, our dear sister said, we're not trying to put you on a pedestal. But you know what I'm trying to say? We love you.
Yes, we do.
Speaking the truth in love. Did you know I can speak? You can speak the word of God. The tongue, in the tongue, there's life and also death. But oh, speaking the truth in love. Did you know why I'm still here? It's because of four-letter word. God loved me.
Yes.
Through Jesus. His death, burial, and resurrection. Yes. Give me the chance to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. That's leading and guiding us into all truth. Every day. It's a beautiful thing to see. Sister Marcia was telling the story. It's wonderful to see somebody, a workman, that knows what they're doing.
Yes.
Skilled. Did you know there's a skill? There's a skill in this book?
Yes, they are.
It's a gift of God to be skilled in the Word of God.
Yes, it is.
If you're skilled in the Word of God, you can become a planter, a seed sower. And every deed that we do, man that's born a woman is a few days and full of trouble, Job said. But oh, the key, here's the key. You know how to get rid of the devil? Resisting.
Yes.
Resisting. How do you resist it? How did Jesus resist it? All the temptations after 40 days and nights, He always said, it is written.
Mm-hmm.
It is
Amen.
Written.
Amen.
This is our textbook. Brother Howard said the word. You may have a tool chest full of tools, mm-hmm. but if you don't have a manual,
mm-hmm.
if you don't have an owner's manual, listen, every automobile has an individual owner's manual mm-hmm. that won't apply, a Ford won't apply to a Chevrolet.
Mm-hmm.
Two different books.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord, for the Word of God.
Yes.
That people, I think, many times my mind comes, a German coming from Germany, at the chance, the threat of his own natural life, brought transcripts into England. And then this book was transcribed that we could read it in English, in our natural home language.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.